Hello, everyone. Welcome to IMTS 2022. My name is Josh Proctor. I want to talk to you in a couple key points about automation. Automation in itself should not be something that should be thought for one user or another. It can be used in any shop that's either small, doesn't have enough programmers, so you can help create the programs faster, or shops that have an excess amount of programmers that need to make programs faster to ease the load on them. Automation has a slew of different items that can assist you in your shop. As for instance, here on my screen, we have our basic parts. Sometimes we need to create stack ups or geometry to assist us inside of our piece. If I run this script for here, we can create a stack up for a vise with just minimal amount of user interface action. Select the side I want to create the fixture on. And based on some technology, it's going to go ahead and recreate steps that you or your programmer would do to create the stack up for this. So here we have a dovetail fixture. Just create a quick clamping operation to lift it up in the air. That is one feature for you can do for the automation. Other items will use actual tool pathing. You would use for tool pathing, you would use your macro database. This hooks into the automation. You can use your macro database to automatically program holes or features, or you can stack it on with the virtual tool database to make any more adjustments or have more variability for your programming. I'm just going to take these basic macros here that I have for a knockout plate, something that mold makers would commonly do to do for their molds. I'm going to go ahead and run this script right here. And again, with some basic user interface, I can just have the operator or machinist go ahead and select some basic items in the Y direction here. The program is now going to go ahead and select a fixture for me, scan all my holes, go ahead and apply any type of routines that I have saved. Again, these are the macros, whether it's feature-based for holes or pocket, or it's color-based for any type of 3D surfacing. So I'm going to automatically create my job list right here. This automation can be used on anything that's as simple as a knockout plate or anything as advanced as a complete mold. All it takes is your save strategies and apply them in a routine that the programmers can understand. Give this thing a moment here to go through. You can see an entire process. This is a knockout plate, as I mentioned before. And the time it takes to do this is essentially as fast as your PC can run. And here we go for the op two. And we can finish off with some milling inside of here. Once it's completed, it turns into a normal hypermill file that can be opened and edited to what you see fits. And to show that it can be used in a multiple series of part, just like the knockout plate, here is the backing plate to that. Running the same script here, and now I'll go ahead and program my second part with some user interface. And I just was able to program two knockout plates and a setup in a matter of minutes here. The functionality of automation allows you to run it in line. You can stop at any point, make alterations, or you can add any type of user interfaces you deem necessary to create your part structure. It is used mostly in part families, but the purpose of automation is to duplicate or replicate a process that will allow you to speed up any type of actions you have. And here, just to show what this script runs here, this is actually what the script looks like. I'm telling it to start up my job list, select any type of items. Here's my user interface for the operations. And it's simply just functions creating stocks, setting some variables, finding my fixtures, and these items come with the software. With the software, you can go ahead and do any type of basic pockets and holes. And in the advanced section, you can do any type of CAD work or any type of advanced features. That's what I have for you today. It's a basic overview of automation. Thank you for watching.